welcome to Cable TV with me, Helen. Tonight at Cable, things are taking a turn for the dark as we welcome the legendary paradigm-shifting Virus Recordings as they celebrate 15 years of momentous beats and bass. With Future Bound, it is my pleasure now to introduce the head honcho of Turbo Recordings, it's Matrix. Matrix.
How you doing?
Great to have you here. Doing well, how are you?
I'm doing good, I've just finished playing.
And it went well?
Yeah, it's absolutely wicked, I loved it.
Fantastic. I wanted to start off by asking you how you first kind of came across drum and bass.
Me and my brother, my brother is optical, and we just kind of started, we got a bit of software from a friend of mine at school, a little music program. We started messing around with that, and that's how we got into music. And I don't think it was actually called drum and bass then, to be honest.
I was gonna actually ask you about the label, obviously, like Optical being a brother. Is there any sibling rivalry between the different labels?
I think Virus is their 15th birthday tonight, and I look back at the early music they made, and I see a lot of people making drum and bass stuff today, and I see it kind of directly links back to what my brother and Ed Rush were doing with, you know, Wormhole. Optical may be my brother, but I kind of view Wormhole as one of the most important albums or most influential albums made out of any drum and bass album.
Well, they pretty much kind of progressed the sounds in the direction
they kind of invented a division of drum and bass, like by bringing techno into it and stuff, you know.
It feels like a few years ago, or like a couple of years ago, everything was kind of all about dubstep pretty much everywhere. Whereas it feels like last year and coming into this year is very much seems to be the year of drum and bass.
It does feel like that, which is nice. I think, you know, any kind of genres of dance music, whether they're necessarily flavor of the month, there's always a good underground scene going on anyway. Speaking as part of the drum and bass scene, it's nice to see it having like a good time of it at the moment, for sure.
What kind of characterizes the Virus sound for you, because it is quite like distinctive in a lot of ways?
I don't know, it's like, I'd say it's dark, it's got kind of it's got a lot of techno and stuff in it, but I think the thing that sets it apart from a lot of people who make similar kind of music is it's got a bit of soul to it somehow. You know, it's not too like
a bit of actual funk.
It's got funk. It doesn't feel like it's sort of made by a computer.
Brilliant, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And now it's that time of the night again, where I hand over to my co-presenter Vivek, who is stroking my face.
So who are you mainly here to see tonight?
Ed Rush and Optical.
Which DJ are you mainly here to see tonight?
Audio.
How's it going? Woo! Guys, who are you here to see tonight?
Yes, we're here to see the Upbeats. Also, was it Black Sun Empire? That's going to be pretty good. I'm usually a Ram man, but I'm here to see Virus.
I came all the way from France for tonight, because I heard about it from my friends, and I came here.
Hello, Chris!
Stay out of trouble, you crazy kids.
Proper fancy me, don't you?
Proper
fancy. How do you feel your life has improved since you've been since you've had this jacket?
Are you seriously asking me that question?
I mean that shit. How has your life improved since you got this fucking jacket?
I can't get enough sleep, mate.
Can't get enough sleep because there's too many ladies.
Nah, man.
Yeah.
I keep just looking at the jacket.
Keep looking at the jacket all day, all night.
All day, all night.
Do you think, like, as good as the jacket makes you look, and it makes you look awesome, do you think it would look better on me, or...?
Do I think the jacket would look better on you? There's only one way to find out.
Let's do it.
Mate, How's your life improved since you had the jacket?
You know what? Since I got this jacket, like, the ladies have been going crazy over me.
I'm very excited now to welcome a man who's been pushing the boundaries of drum and bass at the very beginning, releasing one seminal record after another. It is Ed Rush. So Ed Rush, welcome.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello. A pleasure to have you here.
Pleasure to be here.
You guys just finished your set. How did it go?
It went amazingly well. We had a really good time. It was a nice mixture of some old Virus classics and some upfront stuff. So, yeah, it went down pretty good. I really enjoyed it. I didn't want to come off, actually.
Always a good sign.
Yeah.
And congratulations, 15 years of Virus Recordings. No mean feat.
Yeah, I know. Thank you very much. It's a harsh reality of, it's like a reality check of how old we're getting, but.
If you're gonna look on the bad side.
But it's flown by. It's crazy how quickly it's gone. I can't actually believe it.
Do you miss that kind of analog way of producing ever?
Yeah, I do. I mean, the only drawback with it was you needed more space. So you had to have a larger room to fit all the keyboards and the desk and all that kind of thing in. Whereas now you can sit in a plane seat with some headphones on and write music. I think the analog world was a bit more forgiving in that, you know, when you're writing music in a digital domain, you have to be a lot more clinical, it's a lot more precise. If there's any mistakes, they're kind of a lot more transparent and emphasized. Whereas in the analog world, lots of red lights and using kind of DAT tapes and stuff added natural characteristics to the sound that were more forgiving. So it's a different approach now. I've had to almost, since we started making music in the box, or just in a computer, I've had to almost unlearn all the old analog ways because they're completely different rules that apply now. Those old tricks that we used to do don't really work in a digital world now.
What is next? What can we look forward to?
We have a single from Mephuse and Paul Inside Info that's coming on April 13th, I think the release date is.
Okay.
And then Audio's got some more stuff that he's done for us that he played a couple of bits tonight that sounded amazing. I never heard them before. So to hear them for the first time
in a club,
in the environment with everyone going nuts, it's got me excited about that project, so that'll be cool. Matt and I are currently trying to get this album cracked. It's been
a long time.
Yeah, we're pushing for the end of the year. But you know, it's got, like, we've never really put pressure on ourselves when writing music, and I think if you do, it affects the outcome.
Well, I look forward to it.
Thank you so much.
All
right, cheers.
That was Virus Recordings' 15th birthday bash. Tonight, we've witnessed some unbelievable sets from some of the most forward-thinking DJs in drum and bass. We've chatted to some true legends, and we've generally had a blast. We'll see you next time on Cable TV.
You want me to use my powers to get you in?
Yes. I'm feeling it. Oh my days, I'm feeling it. You've got powers, mate.